would like to invite Kara Cooney to come up here to tell you all about ancient Egypt.
Thank you, Vilika. Thank you, Michael. Thank you, everyone, for coming. Now let's see how I can condense all of this into 5 minutes and do my best. For the last 8 years, I've been looking at hundreds of ancient Egyptian coffins of a particular time period in museums, mostly in Europe because of the Egyptian Revolution, but Louvre, British Museum, in Vienna, and Stockholm, in Paris, and Leiden, and Rome, Florence. I mean, the list goes on. It didn't suck. Let's put it that way, all of that travel. But what does suck is what, I mean, look at these objects. These are extraordinarily complicated objects. They change through time. These are 19th, 20th, and 21st dynasty coffins. Can't you tell? I can tell. And they're incredibly richly detailed. They involve extensive amounts of reuse. So you can see this detail shot here has a 19th dynasty coffin decoration underneath of a 20th dynasty decoration. So there's multiple layers of reuse, multiple layers of use and palimpsest throughout. Sometimes I get to see these coffins up close in museum storage, open them up, look inside, see the extraordinary details that there are to be seen, look at the text, look at the figures. This is wood panel painting at its most complex, on the most complex kind of three-dimensional object that you can imagine that can be opened and closed. And not only that, these are nesting objects, inner coffin, outer coffin, three pieces nested within each other with a wrapped mummy on the inside, with papyri that belonged to the set, found in a tomb with hundreds of other such coffin sets. And so you're dealing with information on a level that is extraordinary, that explodes before my eyes. And so I tried. I thought, okay, I'll make a database. This will be a useful thing, a service to the coffin community. Yes, there is such a thing. And I go to many such conferences, and it's a little strange, but there are creepy and strange people who devote their lives to this kind of social history. And I thought, okay, I'll do a custom FileMaker database. It'll be so interesting. I'll have a tab for reuse. I'll have a tab for the title and the name of the individual. I'll have a tab for the time period. I'll have a tab for the quality of it. How nice is the wood? What kind of wood is it? Is it imported? Is it not? You can see a lot of those tabs here, the provenance. What other coffins is it found with? What other pieces in a set are preserved? The list goes on and on. And then I started to try to input information into this database. And I just threw up my hands in despair, absolute and abject despair. And I thought, if I don't find a way to communicate this information visually, quickly, to tag it, and to include my coffin community who can be a part of this and create a hive mind so that somebody who's working on titles can do this and somebody who's working on reconstructing the provenance can do that, then this is impossible. This is dead in the water. So this database is indeed dead in the water, and it took me hundreds of man hours to realize that. But now I know that we need to move on to something like this, where you can open it and close it and spin it and put it together and take the mummy out and put the mummy back in and click on the name and see, oh, look, that's the name of the person who owned this coffin. But look, it's also reused and there's another name underneath. And isn't that interesting? And you have multiple layers of information, social information, material information, art historical information, provenance and archaeological information, layers and layers that I can't deal with, even for perhaps one coffin in my lifetime. But if we put something like this together and we bring the entire community of coffin-interested people together, then it's not just about coffins, is it? It's about any kind of object you can imagine in the Egyptian Museum in Cairo or in the Louvre or in the British Museum or in the Met. And it's about any kind of object that you can imagine anywhere, from a Rothko painting to a beautiful piece of Japanese ceramics to folk art. So Vilika and I got together and we started to think big. And we started to think of a tagged visual that can be shared amongst scholars of like specializations. And that's where we are now. And let's see how far we can push this truck up the road. Thank you very much. Thank you, sir.